this man? Where did he come from? And where is he going? His name is Ben Kerr, and he's going to great lengths to get you to stop smoking. The former accountant began what some may call his oddball smoke-out odyssey nearly a year ago in a Toronto, Canada office building. Ben Kerr suffers from emphysema, and smoking in the office bothered him so much he felt forced to take some bizarre steps to combat the problem. Ben's co-workers thought he was going off the deep end. Ben's boss said he was overreacting.
Ben and I worked together for the past 10 years. He was a very dependable worker, punctual, thorough. But in the last couple of years, his anti-smoking phobia probably dominated his thoughts to the point where it's just becoming a little bit unreasonable.
After a long struggle, there seemed to be only one course of action.
To the manager, Toronto Harbor Commission, from Ben Kerr. Please accept my resignation. It is with regret that I have to do this, but unfortunately, health is number one in my life.
Now, not too many people would leave a $25,000 a year job just because some co-workers smoked in the office. But Ben Kerr did, and he did it in spades. He took a one-man anti-smoking campaign and turned it into an international crusade. Although his wife and five children were somewhat less than enthusiastic, Ben left his hometown of Toronto in mid-June. With his special air filtering helmet strapped on securely and his shopping cart turned suitcase trailing behind, he set a course for Nashville, Tennessee, the entertainment capital of the South, where he hoped to get some publicity. 30 days and 800 miles later, Ben completed the first leg of his Clean Air for Office Workers campaign. But his hoped-for appearance at the Grand Ole Opry didn't work out. So from there, he turned west. We caught up with Ben just outside Tucson, some 500 miles from his final destination of Los Angeles. Hi, Ben.
Well, hi. How are you?
How far have you gone today?
Well, we got up at the crack of dawn, about 20, 25 miles.
Really? That's great. What do you hope to accomplish by doing this?
Well, it's time smoking was banned in offices, and I think I'm the guy to do it.
Now, most people would say the idea of a 51-year-old man walking 3,000 miles from Toronto to Los Angeles is a bit crazy. But Ben thought it would take an oddball odyssey to draw attention to what he says is a very serious problem. The American Cancer Society says the facts about smoking are frightening. Cigarette smoking is the major cause of lung cancer in both men and women. This year, it's estimated smoking-related lung cancer will claim more than 80,000 lives. Those facts may be grim, but there's plenty of evidence giving up cigarettes lowers the risk of dying from them. And that's where Ben comes in. He's out to save your life by getting you to kick the habit. Not all smokers are ready to be saved, however. Many think smoking bans would be a violation of their rights. What does Ben say to that?
Well, I don't care about their personal rights. If they're going to give me lung cancer or emphysema, they're violating my rights.
Well, Ben, you're not the only one who feels that way. According to the Cancer Society, more than two-thirds of the population believe smoking should be restricted to fewer places. And more than half of all smokers agree. So it's not surprising that over the past 5 years, millions of Americans have quit cold turkey during the society's Great American Smokeout. And if pressure to quit from family, friends, and co-workers weren't enough, how about this? A recent survey of business managers shows most would hire a non-smoker over a smoker if given a choice. But until smoking is completely banned from the office, Ben will continue to wage his anti-smoking campaign just as long and as far as he can. And Ben makes sure he stays fine-tuned for the journeys ahead by being very careful, possibly even too careful, about his diet. Ben, what are you doing with all these carrots?
I'm grating the carrots to make carrot juice.
What's the next step?
Next step is to load the sock.
A sock?
A sock.
Does carrot juice taste better when it's wrung through a sock?
Well, as long as you don't wear the sock first.
Okay. Now, what's your next step?
Wringing it out, just like Grandma used to do. And here's to you. Good stuff.
After spending a day with Ben Kerr, you might be tempted to describe him as a total health nut. But just when you think you've gotten to know all about this eccentric little guy, he springs another surprise. He is, of all things, an aspiring recording star. Okay, Ben, so you're a songwriter. Let's hear one of your songs.
There's fire on one end, a fool on the other. You'd better butt out, or I'll tell Mother, and you know what Father will do to you.
There's fire on one end, a fool on the other. When you get older, you'll discover what smoking cigarettes can do to you.
What do you want to be remembered for?
Getting smoking banned in offices. I would like that on my tombstone. So when you write my obituary, put Ben Kerr, the fellow who got smoking banned in offices.
There's fire on one end, fool on the other. And I'm so glad that you discovered what smoking cigarettes can do to you.